Hey there, and welcome back to Let's Play Grandia 2. Let's go upstairs in the church here, and hopefully we can learn more about the supposed curse that's over this village. Let's talk to the father. I didn't come here to see the view, buddy. So yet again, we get to see the camera pan over the town. But what they're trying to point out here, it's not really obvious. I guess it kind of is, but I didn't pay attention to it the first few times, is those big rock pillar-looking things. Yeah, Elena points it out. They look to be part of a single ruin. So apparently the town was built on top of an old ancient ruin. I mean, that just smells cursed, doesn't it? Or, I don't know. I mean, it seems to me that, you know, if you built a town over the temple of a god, that god would be, you know, kind of pissed off about it. Yep. Rito's gonna kinda put two and two together here. Ruined temple, barrier mound, unholy piece of Valmar sealed up inside. There we go. Terrific, alright. So it looks like there's a possibility that another Seal of Valmar has been broken. I don't recall hunting down Reawakening God of Evil as being part of my job description. That's the main thing, he's not being paid for it. Yeah, and then Elena gets all, well, fine, I'll just go by myself. And then, you know, since our job is to protect her, you know, that's kind of forcing us to come along. Come on, make a nice face for me. We get a unique picture here. What are you doing? Cut that out. I don't know why it makes the dialogue, like you have to advance it right there. That's kind of weird, but whatever.
Oh, Ryudo.
Yeah, that's right. Look at me. I'm the big hero. There is much danger. Okay, so let's get on our way, or we can stop and talk some more. Do not allow darkness to have a doorway to your heart. Well, she's kind of possessed by the wings of Valmar. I think it's a little late for that, but that's just me. Yeah, okay, come on, let's get this over with. Wow. Why does this keep happening? I keep saying things, and then the characters end up saying them right afterwards. I swear I don't remember that, like, half these dialogues are being, are coming up. Because, again, I haven't played this game in a year. I don't remember every single little thing about it. That's so weird. Oh, look, it's Merrig. Hopefully he's not going to try to kill us this time. It offends the earth. Uh-oh. So Melfis is here too? Ah, so we're pleading for his help. Sweet. So Merig is gonna join us. Awesome. And now we've got the Beastman Merig in our party, and he kicks ass too. First of all, let's see if I've got any kind of accessories for him that's any better. Nope, I like his attack. Notice his attack is 192 without any skills, and Ryuto's is 190 with that strength skill. I mean, that's insane by itself. So now I've got somebody else who's twice as powerful, pretty much. Okay, I'm gonna see what kind of skills and magic I can power up real quick, so I'm gonna cut away and then come back afterwards. Okay, and we're back. I didn't really change a whole lot, I just upgraded a few skills here and there. I was gonna give the speed to Merig, but actually Merig's base speed is higher than Ryuto's base speed. So, I don't know, go figure there, you know? Alright, there's the inn, general store, South Celestia Church, and okay, it's not giving me any other places. But where we're gonna wanna go, let's see if I can find it. There we are. It's this spot right here. This is where the excavation was taking place. And this is the hole that they dug to get in. Oh, also, as far as magic is concerned, I just upgraded a few of Rhone's random spells. So, nothing really important there. So it looks like the smell of decay is coming from down below. And obviously that's where we have to go. And of course Ryuto is just going to be the total badass here and just open it by hitting it with the sword. So there we go. And now we are going to be heading into our next dungeon. Hooray, dungeons. Hopefully we won't have to spend millions of years here. You can light these little torches. You don't have to, but you can. I'm gonna put off saving for now. And of course there are multiple pathways. It's kinda nice to have the torches lit so you can tell where you've been already in case you get turned around. So, I mean, if I come across one, I'll light it. It's not like it takes a long amount of time or anything. I think these enemies are the same, actually, I think. Which is kind of ridiculous. Yeah, we've got giant mantises and crag snakes. I mean, you know, not really that big of a deal. Especially since we've got Merig now, too. We have four people in our party. Okay, they're going to finish off that snake over there. So let's have Merig take care of that crag snake. Ooh, look at that damage, 358 with a counter. It's pretty good. Merig is a wonderful addition to the party. He kicks so much butt in this game. And once you start getting skills, like, once you start getting more skill books to actually make him stronger, it's just absolutely crazy how good of a character Merig is. Alright, so we took care of that one. That was really easy. We can't go this way. And a dead end with a healing herb. So we get to go back. I think we can go this way. Yeah, I've already been here, so let's take the other path. Ooh, more enemies. Yeah, I'll just leave this fight in, I guess. I got initiative and stuff. Same enemies, but you can't get too much of seeing Merig, right? Let's take out that frog. He probably won't be able to do it by himself. Elena could help. And Merig can finish off that mantis. Wow! Was Elena just doing 155 damage? The answer is yes, and that's because her staff is fire-based, and apparently those frogs are weak to fire, so Go figure, right? Or not the frogs, but the mantises. Notice how the numbers were really big? That indicates that the attack you're using, it's like an elemental weakness. I don't really care about that too much, honestly, you know, but whatever. Anyway, well, let's light this torch here real quick, and I'm gonna cut it off here, so we can continue on through this dungeon and hopefully make some more progress. So, hope you enjoyed this part, thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.